हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ इज़ रोशनी परीख, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल। नाउ टूडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ एसी। नाउ ओवरव्यू ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज गिवन हियर, विच इंक्लूड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी, आरएमएस और इफेक्टिव वैल्यू, एवरेज वैल्यू एंड द फेजर रिप्रेजेंटेशन। मीन्स आई विल डिस्कस ईच एंड एवरी सब टॉपिक स्टेप बाय स्टेप। फर्स्ट लेट्स सी दी डेफिनेशन ऑफ ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी। वॉट डज मीन बाई द ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटीज? तो सी हियर, ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी मीन्स द क्वांटिटीज विच मैग्नीट्यूड एंड द डायरेक्शन चेंजेस कंटिन्यूसली विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी। ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ साइन वेव। इफ यू प्लॉट द क्वांटिटीज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, देन यू विल गेट द साइन वेव। सो सी हियर, in this picture you can see the waveform which is sine in a nature, means sinusoidal in a nature, e versus omega t. e that is the emf, alternating emf, and omega t that is the omega, that is the angular frequency, and t that is the time. So plotted the value of a emf with respect to omega t, so you will get the sine wave. तो दिस साइन वेव इट्स कॉल अ ऑल्टरनेटिंग साइकिल। मीन्स ई एम एफ हैविंग दिस साइन वेव इन अ नेचर, सो इट इज़ कॉल अ ऑल्टरनेटिंग ई एम एफ। नाउ सी, देर आर अ इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस ऑफ द ए सी। फर्स्ट डेट इज़ द एम्पलीट्यूड। एम्पलीट्यूड मीन्स वॉट? एम्पलीट्यूड मीन्स द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू इज कॉल अ मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ द, और यू कैन से पीक वैल्यू। तो द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू और अ पीक वैल्यू ऑफ द ऑल्टरनेटिंग क्वांटिटी इज कॉल अ एम्पलीट्यूड, एंड विच अकर ट्वाइस इन अ वन साइकिल। सी हियर, के हियर ई एम एफ साइकिल इज अ गिवन। सो प्लस ई एम एंड माइनस ई एम बोथ आर द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू। प्लस ई एम, ई एम एफ अटेन्स द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू एट अ पाई बाई टू डिग्री, पाई बाई टू रेडियन, एंड सेम वे also attains the maximum value in the negative at the 3 pi by 2 radians. So in a one cycle it attains the maximum value twice in a one cycle, one during the positive half cycle and one during the negative half cycle. So maximum value is called a amplitude, or you can say a peak value. Same way, what is the time period? So time period is a, if I say के one complete alternation is called a cycle, one complete alternation is called a cycle which having a one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle. So one cycle means a one complete set of a positive values and the negative values. So what is the time period? So see here, a capital T, that is the time period. Time period means time taken by the alternating quantity to complete one cycle, that is known as the time period, which is in the second. Now next term, that is the instantaneous value. Instantaneous value means the value of the alternating quantity at any instant, that is called a instantaneous value, which is denoted by the small letter. If I say ke see here, emf versus omega t, तो ई एम एफ वैल्यू इज़ कंटिन्यूसली चेंजिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू ओमेगा टी। सो द वैल्यू ऑफ द ई एम एफ एट एनी इंस्टेंट, देन इट इज़ कॉल अ इंस्टेंटेनियस वैल्यू, विच इज़ ऑलवेज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ स्मॉल लेटर। सेम वे, वॉट इज़ अ फ्रीक्वेंसी? तो फ्रीक्वेंसी मीन्स द नंबर ऑफ साइकिल कंप्लीटेड इन अ वन सेकंड, दैट इज कॉल अ फ्रीक्वेंसी। फॉर इंडिया इट इज़ द 50 हर्ट्ज। एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी, वॉट इज़ द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड द टाइम पीरियड? तो टाइम पीरियड, फ्रीक्वेंसी डेट इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन टाइम पीरियड, वन अपॉन टी। इफ टाइम पीरियड इज अ मोर, मीन्स टाइम पीरियड मीन्स द टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट द वन साइकिल। इफ इट इज अ मोर, देन द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज अ लेस, मीन्स द नंबर ऑफ साइकिल कंप्लीटेड इन अ वन सेकंड इज अ लेस। एंड इफ टाइम पीरियड इज अ लेस, देन द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज अ मोर। सो दिस वे वाइस वर्सा इज देयर। नाउ वॉट इज द एवरेज वैल्यू? तो सी, एवरेज वैल्यू मीन्स you can find out the suppose here I, that is the alternating current which is a sine wave in a nature, then how can you find out the average value? So average value means the arithmetic average of all the values of an alternating quantity over one cycle is called its average value. So mathematically, you can derive the equation for the average value is average value, that is the area under one cycle divided by the base. Now see here, one cycle having the two half cycle, one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle. So you can take the average of one half cycle. So base of the one half cycle, that is the pi, and take the integration area under the one half cycle. So from 0 to pi. So see, as we know that k voltage, that is for the AC Vm sin omega t, and the alternating current equation, that is I is equal to Im sin omega t. So how can you take the average? Average is equal to integration of 0 to pi I d theta, or you can say I d omega t, divided by base of the half cycle, that is the pi. So see here, I average is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to pi I d omega t, means integrate with respect to omega t. Now what is the I? I is equal to alternating cycle, means alternating current, and alternating current is given by Im sin omega t. So substitute that the value of the current I, that is the Im sin omega t omega t. Now Im, that is the constant, to take out from the integration. So Im by pi, and integration of 0 to pi sin omega t, what is the integration of sin omega t? That is the minus cos omega t divided by omega. So here I am taking the integration with respect to omega. So what is the integration of sin omega t? That is the minus cos omega t. And simply put the upper limit minus lower limit. So minus cos pi minus cos 0. So you will get this value, average value, that is the 2Im. If I say ke integration of sin omega t, that is the minus cos omega t, and minus cos omega t, put the upper limit minus lower limit. So minus cos pi minus minus cos 0. Now what is the put the value of a cos pi, and same way cos 0, you will get the 2Im by pi. So finally you will get the average value, that is the 0.637Im. Means the average value, that is the maximum value into the 0.637, means the average value, that is the 0.637 times of the maximum value. Now what is the RMS value? So see here, alternating cycle means what? K alternating quantity which magnitude continuously changes with respect to the time. So how can you represent the AC value? So AC value is represented by the RMS value. So RMS value is equal to what? And how can you derive the equation for the RMS? So the effective or RMS value of an alternating quantity is the steady current which, when flowing through a given resistor for a given period of a time, to produce the same amount of the heat which is produced by the alternating quantity when flowing through the same resistor for a same value of the time. So it is related to the, if I say ke two resistor are there, means the circuit is the same, resistor, the value of a resistor is the same. One resistor is connected to the DC supply and one resistor is connected to the AC supply. Then RMS value, that is the DC value of the current when flowing through the same resistor to produce the same amount of the heat which is produced by the, when AC current is flowing through the same resistor for a same period of a time to produce the same amount of a heat. So that value of the DC, that is the equivalent of the AC. So that AC is called a RMS value. So how can you find out the RMS value? RMS value, that is the root mean square. Root mean square means what? K root of area under the square curve divided by base. Now as we noted, K one cycle having a 2 pi radian occupy the, one cycle having a 2 pi radian of a cycle. So what is the base? That is the 2 pi. And area under the curve. So if you want to find out the area under the curve, then integrate the current or a voltage for 0 to 2 pi with respect to omega t. So see here, if you want to take the RMS value of the voltage, then what will be the equation of the VRMS? VRMS is equal to root of 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi V square omega t. You have to take the integration of the instantaneous value of a voltage, and here a root mean square. So take the square of the voltage and then make the root. Same way, if you want to derive the equation for the current, then IRMS is equal to root of 1 upon 2 pi. 2 pi, that is the base of a 1 cycle. 0 to 2 pi, take the integration of the 1 cycle. So, limit is 0 to 2 pi. I square d omega t. Now, what is the I? I, that is the instantaneous value of a current, which is given by I m sine omega t. So, see here, when you put the value of a I, that is the I m sine omega t. So, I m square sine square omega t d omega t. I m square, that is the constant. So, take out from the integration. Integration of sine square omega t. So, what is the sine square? 1 minus cos square omega t. And then, you can say 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2. And do the integration. And finally, you will get the after the integration, put the upper limit minus lower limit. And you will get the RMS value, that is the maximum value divided by root 2. So, this way you can derive the equation for a voltage or a current for the RMS value. Now, what is the form factor and what is the peak factor? These are also a main factor in the AC. Form factor, that is the ratio of a RMS value to the average value. If you put the RMS value, that is the, if I say voltage is there, then Vm by root 2. Then if I say current is there, then Im by root 2. And what is the average value? 2 Im by pi. So, if you put the RMS values and the average values equation, then you will get the form factor, that is the 1.1. See here, a form factor, that is the I RMS upon I average. So, what is the RMS? Im by root 2, 1 upon root 2, that is the 0.707 Im. What is the average? As I discussed, that average value, that is the 2 Im by pi, 2 by pi, that is the 0.637 Im. Im, Im cancel out. Then you will get the form factor, that is the 1.11. Now, what is the same way? Form factor is remains the same for the current or for the voltage or for any alternating quantity. It is just a ratio of a RMS value to the average value. Now, what is the peak factor? Peak factor, that is the maximum value divided by RMS. So, maximum value Im, RMS value, that is the 0.707 Im. Im, Im cancel out. 1 upon 0.707, you will get the 1.414. So, that is the peak factor. Now, what is the phasor representation? If we are represent the alternating quantity with respect to any position, with respect to any variable component like the omega t or any angle with in a degree or a radian, then that position is called a phase. So, an alternating quantity can be represented by either using the waveform or by the equation form or by the phasor diagram. So, see here, a phasor is given, is there. A 360 degree of a circle is there and rotate in an anti-clockwise direction with the omega radian per second angular velocity, means angular frequency. So, this way you can represent in the phasor way. Now, see, what is the phase? As I said, that the position of the alternating quantity with respect to the any reference, that is called a phase. You can take a reference as any variable component like the time or an angle. Angle is in a degree or in a radian. Now, what is a phase difference? When two quantities are there, when two alternating quantities are there, then there is a difference in the phases are there. Suppose if both quantities are starts the same time, attains the maximum value at the same time and attains again zero value at the same time, then it is called in a phase. There is a no phase difference is that. See here, in phase, first waveform, voltage and current, both are starts from the zero, attains the maximum value at the same time at the pi by 2 radian, then again zero value attains at the pi, then again attains the maximum value in the negative half cycle same time, that is at a 3 pi by 2 radian, and again attains the zero value at the 2 pi. So, both quantity, voltage and current, attains the maximum as well as zero value at the same time. So, it is called a in phase. There is a no phase difference between our two quantities. And the equation of voltage, that is the Vm sine omega t, and current equation will be a Im sine omega t. There is a no phase difference. Phi is represented the phase difference. phi is equal to 0. So in a vector, v and I both are in a one line. Now, another, that is the lagging. Lagging means what? If current is lag behind the voltage by any angle, then it is called a lagging. See, in a second waveforms, voltage starts from the zero, but after a 5 degree, current starts to flow. So there is a difference of a phi is there. Your current is a lagging behind the voltage by an angle of a phi. So it is called a lagging power factor, or you can say lagging phase. So see here, a voltage is as a reference vector on the x-axis Vm, but your current Im, that is in a fourth quadrant, which is lag behind the voltage by an angle of a phi. So it is called a lagging. Lagging means your current lag behind the voltage by an angle of a phi. Current voltage se piche hota hai, तो उसको हम लैग बोलते हैं. एंड लैगिंग इज ऑलवेज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय माइनस फाइ, माइनस साइन इन फ्रंट ऑफ ए फाइ. सो सी, वोल्टेज इक्वेशन रिमेंस द सेम, दैट इज द वी इज इक्वल टू वी एम साइन ओमेगा टी, वेर एवर आई इज इक्वल टू आई एम साइन ओमेगा टी माइनस फाइ. माइनस इंडिकेट द लैगिंग एंड फाइ, दैट इज इंडिकेट द फेस डिफरेंस बिटवीन द वोल्टेज वैक्टर एंड द करंट वैक्टर. नाउ another, that is the leading. Leading means what? Ke if the current is lead the voltage by an angle of a phi, then it is called a leading. Lead means current voltage se aage hai. See here, in the waveform, voltage starts from the zero, but current is already started at an angle of a phi, which is the leading angle. Means current is already starts to flow, and after the angle of a phi, your voltage starts to flow. So see here, in a vector diagram, V, that is the reference vector on the x-axis, but your current, that is in a first quadrant, means current lead the voltage by an angle of a phi. So if leading phase difference is red, then it is denoted by the plus phi. Phi, that is the phase difference between the voltage and current vector, and plus indicate the lead sign. So there are three types of phase differences are there: in phase, lagging, and leading. In phase means there is a no phase difference is there, phi remains the zero, and V and I both are in the phase, and V and I both attains the zero value as well as the maximum value at the same time, simultaneously. Wherever in a lagging, your current is lags behind the voltage by an angle of a phi. Phi can be anyone from 0 to 90 degree. Or same way, what is a leading? In leading, the current lead the voltage by an angle of a phi. Lagging always indicated by minus in front of a phi, and leading indicated by a plus sign in front of a phi. Hope you understood. Thank you.